Hello students. Hi everyone. I am Srikant. We are discussing about programming in C language. See, on that we are discussing about program fundamentals. Okay, the agenda of this session about programming languages, classification, comparison, history, users and suitable examples. See, in the previous video session we had discussed in detail about what is program, what is programming language and various programming languages, generations of programming languages and with the examples we discussed, right? So in this session, I try to give much more clarity over about classification of programming languages, comparison and history, users, and we need to concentrate where this C language, C history, everything we can find out here, okay? See, what is program here? The set of instructions is technically termed as what? Program. The process of creating program is called what? Programming. A programming language is a computer language used to write instructions for the computer in a well-defined format. See, a computer program is what? Collection of instructions that can be executed by a computer to perform a specific task. A computer program is usually written by a computer programmer in a programming languages. See, we discussed in previous sessions like programming languages like low level language, machine level language, assembly level language, high level languages like imperative languages, functional languages, declarative languages and object oriented languages. I explained already all these third generation languages, fourth generation, first and second generation languages, right? So in this session, I try to discuss in detail about what is imperative, what is functional, what is declarative languages, object oriented languages and history of those languages, okay? So observe here, majorly these programming languages are classified by these types like low level language, high level language. The low level language again categorized by what? Machine language and assembly language. High level languages categorized by what? Procedural languages, also called what? POPL, procedural oriented programming language. Non-procedural oriented programming languages and problem oriented programming language. In case of procedural oriented programming language, again it categorized by what? Algorithmics, object oriented and a scripting language. Non-procedural languages like functional language, logic based language and database languages. Problem oriented like numerical, symbolical, publishing. See, these are all what various types of programming languages are using in the real world environment. Okay, see, we try to discuss in detail. See, what is this procedural language? See, this procedural language is nothing but type of computer programming language that specifies a series of well-structured steps and procedures within its programming context to compose a program. It contains a systematic order of what? Statements, functions and commands to complete a computational task of a program. See, such type of programming languages are called procedural language. See, best examples like Basic, C, Fortran and Pascal. These are all what? Procedural language. Here remember, what is C language? We got another definition, right? C, previously we discussed, C is a third generation language. C is a high level language. C is a structural oriented programming language. Now C is what? Procedural oriented programming language. Okay. See, algorithmic. Here, algorithmic language is nothing but, it's a family of portable programming languages for scientific computations that had a strong influence on what? Other languages. See, these are what? High language designed for forming convenient expression of what? Procedures used in the solution of a wide class of problems. See, in this language, the programmers must specify the steps the computer has to follow while executing a program. Okay, so always remember, in case of algorithmic related language, we must write the sequence of step by step of the solution of the given problem. Such type of languages are called algorithmic language. Okay, examples like COBOL, like Fortran, C, some other languages also there, like BCPL, B, Pascal, PLI, Simula. See, these are all what? These algorithmic related language. Okay, simply remember. So it is based on what? Providing a solution of a given problem in the form of step-by-step manner, sequential manner. Such type of language is called algorithmic language. See, coming to the object-oriented language. See, this is object-oriented language is what? High-level computer language that implements what? Objects and their associated procedures with the programming context to create software program. See, this object-oriented programming technique that binds what? Related data and functions into an object. Okay. See, objects are what? Self-contained modules that contain data as well as what? Functions need to manipulate the data with the same module. So simply can remember, sometimes we may call it is OOPS, object-oriented programming system or synopsis concept, like class, object, data abstraction, data encapsulation, polymorphism, inheritance. Such type of programming languages are called object-oriented programming languages. Best example like C++, Java, .NET. These are all comes under what? Object-oriented programming language. Okay. But C is what type of programming language? C is a structural-oriented programming language. C is a procedural-oriented programming language. Okay. Here you can also remember one more point. C is what? Top to bottom approach. It's executing the instructions step by step. But these C++, Java, these are all what? Bottom to top approach. Okay. I will explain through programmatically how it is working and functioning. Okay. See, remember when we can call a language is object-oriented programming language, that language must support object-oriented concepts like class, object, data abstraction, data encapsulation, inheritance, polymorphism, like reusable code, message communications, data abstraction. So these are all comes under what? Object-oriented programming language. Okay. See, C is not object-oriented. C is only what? Procedural-oriented, algorithmic-oriented, structural-oriented programming language. Remember this point. See, next one is scripting. See, a script or scripting language is a computer language with a series of commands within a file that is capable of being executed without being compiled. Okay. The statement is going to be what? Capable of being executed without being what? Compiled. See, several examples like Perl scripting, PHP scripting, Python scripting, like say JavaScript, client-side scripting language is called JavaScript. See, the main advantages of scripting languages like open source, allowing user to view and edit the script if needed, does not require the file to be compiled, but maybe when necessary, easy to learn and write, easy to port between what different operating systems. It is much faster to develop than an actual program. Okay. See, these are all about what scripting languages. See, in our academics or software engineering environment based on, say for front end technologies, there JavaScript is going to be used. Okay. JavaScript related frameworks, scripting languages are going to be used. Like several examples like VB script, Perl script, JavaScript, these are all what? Various scripting languages. Okay. See, these are all comes under what? Procedure. These syntax must follow. Based on that syntax only, you need to write the code in the form of particular sequential manner in the way top to bottom approach or bottom to top approach like that. But in case of non-procedural, here you need to be not care about case sensitives. We can give the instructions in the form of declaratively upper or lower cases. But in case of procedural languages, case is also important. Like small alphabetical, capital alphabetical is also very important. What? Procedural oriented programming language. Case is very important. Syntax is very important while developing or constructing procedural oriented programming languages. Remember it. Okay. So these are all the examples: algorithmic, object oriented, scripting. These are all comes under what? Procedural oriented programming language. And next we go with problem-oriented languages. See, these problem-oriented languages were designed to solve what? Specific problems. Okay. See, these query languages, application generators, these are all comes under what? Problem-oriented languages like numerical, like MATLAB, symbolic, Mathematica, publishing like LaTeX. See, these are all comes under what? Problem-oriented language. So another one is non-procedural languages. Non-procedural languages is nothing but what? These languages allows the programmer to focus on what to do rather than what, how to do it. See, this is because these languages does not focus as much on individual process need to get to the conclusion, but rather on ways to get to the conclusion itself. See, this is why non-procedural languages is often referred to as a declarative languages. Non-procedural languages are is nothing but what? Declarative. These procedural languages are like imperative languages. Generally, these languages are majorly used for these two purposes. One is imperative languages, another called what? Declarative languages. Okay. See, several examples like functional languages, logical based languages, database related languages. Okay. What is these functional languages? These functional languages solve a problem by applying what? Set of functions to the initial variables in specific ways to get the answer. The functional programming style relies on the data of function application rather than on the notation of variables and assignments. A program written in a functional language is consisting of what? Function calls together with arguments to what? Function. Examples like Lisp, ML, Perl, Python are the examples of what? Functional languages. Okay. See, sir, what is function? What are the built-in functions, user-defined functions, advanced functions? We try to discuss in detail with programmatically, but here theoretically try to understand here what is procedural language, what is non-procedural language, what is problem-oriented languages. These are all comes under what? High-level languages. Okay. Next one is logical-based programming languages. So you say programming languages based on what? Formal logic. A program written in a logic programming language is a set of sentences in a logical form expressing facts and rules about some problem domain. Logic programming languages are important because of their declarative nature, their potential power and flexibility, and their suitability for execution on what? Highly parallel architectures. So major logic programming languages families included what? Prolog. Okay. Like answer set programming like ASP and Datalog. So these are all the best examples of what? Logic based programming languages. Remember, these declarative languages are majorly done with what? Functional languages and logic based programming languages. So another type, database. We discussed in previous video session about what is database, like database management system, database crude operations like creating, reading, updating, deleting, fetching the records, and we are trying to manage the records over the databases, right? See, here we are using in the next level like query languages. It enables users who are not programmers to use certain easily understandable commands to search and generate reports from a database. Okay. Like all these are all query related languages are used in what? Databases. Simply we can call SQL, structured query language. In advanced level, PLSQL, programming language of what? Structured query languages. This is completely managed by what? Persistent layer or data layer or database layer. Simply you can remember, whatever the data operations at doing at a front end side or business logic layer, the data is going to be stored permanently in what? This area, this layer is called databases. Okay, fine. See, this is about programming languages. Generally, it categorizes two types. One is low level language, another one is called high level language. In case of low level language, we discussed previously about machine language. Here, directly user giving instructions directly in the form of what? Machine understandable language, like binary language, represented by what? Zeros and ones representation. In case of assembly language, they are going to be introduced here some mnemonics, like short forms like add, load, count, subtraction, like that. They are going to be using some mnemonics. Instead of completely using machine level language, instead of completely using high level language, they are going to be using one intermediary language called assembly language. They're generally using what? Symbolical representation called mnemonics. Here, language translator is required. In machine language, not required any language translator. But assembly language, language translator required. That language translator is called assembler. Assembler is responsible to convert what? Assembly level language into what? Machine understandable language. So these two in detail I explained already in the previous video sessions. I hope everyone is clear about what? Classification of programming languages. Like low level language called machine level language, assembly level language. High level languages are called procedural oriented programming language. These languages are completely based on procedure of particular language. This is case sensitive language. You must follow rules and regulations of the particular programming language. Otherwise, immediately throws what? Compile time errors. Compiler is responsible to generate what? Compile time errors. And interpreter is going to be responsible to generate what? Runtime errors. Okay. Interpreting at what? Runtime. See, you need to care about here syntax and semantics. That to be case and sensitive, like small a, capital A has a differences in these languages. Sometimes we may also call it as imperative languages. But in case of non-procedural languages, here these languages, instead of looking what to do rather than what, how to do it. Okay. Here you may give instructions in the form of what, upper cases or lower cases, no issue. Okay. But some programming languages are strictly maintained. Some languages are not maintained. You can give the instructions in what, upper cases or lower cases, no issue at all here. Okay. Especially in the querying, while querying a data into the databases, like it categorizes functional languages, logical based languages and databases. Okay. And problem oriented languages, like it's going to be work on specific problem like numerical, symbolical, publishing. See, these are all what, various different types of programming languages. Okay. See, we try to discuss in detail. Here, generally, these programming languages are categorized mainly two approaches. One is called imperative programming, another called declarative programming. Just only we discussed, right? In case of imperative programming, focuses on how to execute. It defines what? Control flow as statements that changes a program state. Especially using here what, control flow, like looping statements are going to be, conditional control statements are going to be using. Based on the control flow, the program state has been changed in imperative programming. But in case of declarative programming, focuses on what? What to execute, not how to do. It concentrates what? What to execute. It defines what completely? Program logic, but not what? Detailed control flow. See, I will explain. Here I explain theoretically. Don't worry. We'll discuss in detail programmatically when we are working on the program. Just you can remember, imperative programs concentrate what? How to do. How it is going to be executing. How it is working. Based on this control flow, program state has been changed. But in case of declarative programming, it won't concentrate how to do. It concentrates what? What to execute based on what particular programming language. But it won't worry about what? Control flow. Generally, it measures the programming language in what? Procedural programming and structured programming, functional programming, object-oriented programming. What is this procedural programming, structured programming? In the before slide only, I explained, right? It specifies the steps a program must take to reach a desired state. See, in this case, in structural programming, especially, it works on what? Like algorithmic manner, step by step, a sequence of steps providing a solution of given problem. Okay. In case of functional programming, it reads program as evaluating what? Mathematical functions and avoids the state and mutable data. And coming to object-oriented programming language, it's going to be enable some concepts like class, object, data abstraction, encapsulations, polymorphism, inheritance. Like it's going to be provides what? Concepts of high level comparatively what? This is structured programming languages. It organizes program as in the form of what? Objects. In object-oriented programming, everything comes under in the form of what? Class and objects. These data structures consisting of data fields and methods together with their instructions. Simply, you can remember all these properties and functions are embedded in what? One name called objects in object-oriented programming. Okay. Don't worry, we'll discuss practically how, what is this object, what is the syntax of object, how it is using this object with the object-oriented programming languages like C++ and Java, .NET and so on. Okay. Some common types of programming like event-driven programming. These program control flows is determined by what? Based on events, like such as sensor inputs or some user actions like mouse click event or key press event, such kind of based on event, these programmings are going to be working. Or messages from other programs or threads. Those are all comes under event-driven programming. Based on some event, the programming language is going to be work. Okay. Automata-based programming. A program or part is treated as a model of a finite state machine or any other formal automations. Okay, used in what? Automation. So reactive programming is a declarative programming concerned with the data streams and the propagation of changes. So these are all what main approaches like imperative and declarative. These are all what measuring programming languages and common type of programming languages. Remember here, we are learning programming in C language. Programming C language is what? Procedural oriented programming language, and it is what? Structural programming language. You need to remember up to these points. Okay. Also, I provided in detail explanation about various things, but you need to remember those two. See, mainly using for two purpose, I told. Imperative, see, observe here, we discussed, right? Imperative language, functional language, and declarative. But basically, these three comes under what? Third generation languages. We know third generation languages are what? High level languages, right? See, imperative, how to do, concentrates. Declarative, what to do, concentrates. Functional language, it going to be provides a solution of what? See, what is the exact solution we need to provide for particular functionality? Like simply I can give sum. Summation function. It sum is a function performs only addition of two numbers. Sum of numbers. Subtraction, it going to be do only functionality of what? Subtraction. Multiplication means it do only multiplication. Division means what? Only division. Like factorials, palindromes. Based on the particular functionality, it going to be work on particular functionalities. Those are all comes under what? Functional related languages. Anyhow, we go with one by one. Imperative languages, just only we spoken about what to do. Imperative languages are concentrated about what to do. Step-by-step procedures. These are all comes under about imperative languages. Generally, it specifies a sequential algorithm using declarations, expressions, and statements. Sir, declarations is nothing but what? Providing or declaring some variables. Okay. See, what is variable? What is data types? We'll discuss in detail in the next level programming. Just remember, declaration part is there. There we are going to be declaring some data or data types with variables. Expressions, what to do, like addition or subtraction or multiplication, division. What is the expression using that data variables? And next, statement like do something or perform something, some action should be do. See, a statement might assign an expression to a variable or use the value of variable to alter the program's control flow. That comes under what? A statement expressions. See, these are all comes under what? Imperative languages. Several examples here I provided for imperative languages like ADA, ALGOL, BASIC, C. These are all comes under what? Imperative languages. These are all languages are imperative languages. Okay. And declarative language. The point you need to remember, this step is fair enough. What to do? And here performing step-by-step procedures in the imperative language. Okay. C is what? Imperative language. You need to remember it. Declarative languages. Declarative programming language describes what computation should be performed and not how to compute it. In imperative, we discussed what to do, how to do. Okay, like completely we are talking about what, how to do this is going to be working here. But here, don't worry about how to compute it. Just what computation is going to be required, that comes under what? Declarative. It focuses on what? What to execute. It defines program logic, but not detailed control flow. But in imperative, we are learning with complete control flow. But in declarative, not required. What to execute is enough. Okay. See, these principles generally based on what? Functional languages and logical languages. Okay. Best examples, these are all various programming languages of what? Declarative languages. Okay. Several like Analytica and like Cypher, DASL, ECL. Okay. Several languages like these are all what? declarative languages like SQL. In SQL, only DQL operations like XBase, XSL transformation, these are all concerned about declarative languages. This concentrates about functional languages and what? Logical languages. Okay. And functional programming. See, if in functional programming, programs are constructed by applying and composing what? Functions. Like what you want. It describes what the end result is based on what? Function calls, higher order functions, recursions. These are all using what? Functional programming. See, it is evolving from the what? Lambda calculus in mathematics. See, it created by what? John Backers to support the functional level programming in 1977. See, in functional programming system is based on the use of a fixed set of combining forms called functional forms. Functional programming languages define programs and subroutines as mathematical functions. See, it treats program as what? Evaluating mathematical functions and avoids state and what? Mutable data. See, several examples of functional programming languages. These are all what? Several examples of what? Functional programming languages. Okay. So just remember it about these two languages, like imperative languages, declarative languages, like how to do, what to do, and why, what you want, and provide complete result, end result in functions, in functional programming languages. Okay. Here, several paradigma like imperative, structured, procedural, functional, event-driven, object-oriented, declarative, and automated-based programming. See, this is what explained in detail up to here, right? See, just remember here, C is what? Imperative language. C is what? Structured language. C is what? Procedural language. Okay? You can remember these 3 points about C language. Okay? Coming to the various system languages, like these are all the several system languages, like I given some, like C language. C is going to be introduced by Mr. Dennis Ritchie in the year 1969, influenced by what? BCPL. Where it is used for? It is used for what? Most operating systems like kernel, including what? Windows NT and most Unix-like systems. Several languages are there here. EP, EPSOL, PLI, PL360, C language, PLS, BLISS, PL8, PL6, SYMPL, C++. C++ is high-level language introduced by Zarin, right? 1979 for C++ applications. ADA, D language, NIM, Rust, Swift. These are all used for what? System-related languages. Used for what? Specific system purpose. Okay? See. And coming to the various history of languages, we'll discuss one by one. Early 1950s, these are all the several languages are introduced. Okay? Like in 1946, ENIAC short code, right? We discussed ERC assembly, short codes. These are all what various languages are introduced in 1950s earlier. Okay? For various analytical engine purpose, okay, non-unique languages, ENIAC coding system, ENIAC short codes, these all what early 1950s they are going to be introduced, name of these languages, okay. And coming to early 1960s, observe, this is a short code, okay, 1950s, like these languages, assembler, 1954-55 in between Fortran, like 1956-58 like Lisp language, 1957-58 like Unicode language, like various languages are introduced in early 1960s. From 1950s to 1959, these many languages are there, okay? Like in early 1970s, observe like Algol 60, in 1960s, it produces like Algol 58. Like COBOL, like Fortran 4 implementation. See, advanced level, it's going to be started with one language. They are going to be keep on improving in the next languages, in the next generations. Okay, like basic language in 1964, like based on Fortran 2 and JAWS. Like in 1967, BCPL language, like introduced by Martin Richards, based on CPL. Like 1969, B language, introduced by Ken Thompson with the contributions from what? Dennis Ritchie. Based on what? BCPL. Like several 1970s early languages. These many languages are there. Here I added main and like most useful languages I added. So many languages also there. Okay. In early 1980s, observe like Pascal language introduced in 1970s, okay, like Algol, based on predecessors like Algol 60, Algol W, and 1971s like CDL, compiler description language, 1972, K and R C language, see, okay, Yeah, see the C language introduced in which year? See, 1969, introduced by Dennis Ritchie. Okay, so observe again after the 1969s, after that 1972, K and RC introduced Dennis Ritchie. Based on which languages? B language, BC, we are all girls 68. They are introduced K and RC language 1972. Like SQL, introduced like company IBM. Predecessors like Alpha and QL, like several languages, C Shell, BillJoy, based on what? C language. So using C, they are going to be constructed what? Next level languages like C Shell. Okay, so observe like C with the classes, introduced in 1980s, based on C language, similar 67. Okay, and also introduced what? C Basic, 1980s and 81, based on basic compiler system, digital resources. 1983, Objective C, they are introduced based on Smalltalk and C. Brad Cox is going to be introduced. C++ in 1983, introduced by what? Zorin. With the name, previously the name is called C with classes. Later it renamed as C++. Like Perl language in 1987, Larry Wall, based on which languages? C, Z, AWK, SS, like. See, these are all what? Various languages of early 1990s. And coming to the 2000, early 2000s, like the J language is introduced, like Python. In 1991, Python is introduced, like Gudo Van Rossum is introduced, ABC and C language. Based on ABC and C language, they're introduced Python by Gudo Van Rossum, like Visual Basics, Borland, Pascal, okay? See, try to look out here how this C is going to be used. Java is introduced in 1995, Mr. James Gosling at Sun Microsystem. Based on which languages like C, Simla, 67, C++, Smalltalk, ADA 83, Objective C, MESA, like various combination of all these things, they are going to be introduced one high-level programming languages like Java by Mr. James Gosling at Sun Microsystem in the year 1995. Like LiveScript, PHP introduced 1995, based on Perl, okay? Like 1995, they are introduced JavaScript, okay, based on LiveScript. And like 1996, VBScript, introduced by Microsoft, based on Visual Basics, like ECMA script, based on JavaScript, like that. See, all these. And next, 1999, C99 is introduced, okay, C99. See, this is about various versions. And early 2010s, like 2000, C# is introduced, like Visual Basic .NET, Scala, C++ 2003, like Groovy, Windows PowerShell. Several languages are there. Here I mentioned like major points of major languages. Like early 2020s, like C++ 2011, they introduced based on C++, standard C and C language. Like TypeScript, based on JavaScript and CoffeeScript. Crystal, based on Ruby, C, Rust, Go, C#, Python. See, these are all what various languages are introduced. C++ 2014, again based on C++ standard C, okay? Like C++ 2017, based on these languages. C18, see, these are all what various history of languages, okay? See, here in this session, we discussed in detail about what is programming languages, in detail about classification of programming languages like low level language, high level language. In the low level language, we discussed in detail machine level language, assembly level language. And coming to the high level language, we discussed in detail about what? Procedural oriented programming language, non-procedural oriented programming language, and problem oriented programming language. Here, basically, these languages are used mainly two purposes, like imperative and declarative languages, okay, and functional language. See, the C is what? Procedural oriented programming language. C is what? Imperative language. C is what? Structural oriented programming language. See, these are all what various definitions found in the classification of various programming language. And also I given some in detail explanation over what? History of languages, okay. I hope all are understood about in detail about classification of programming languages, okay. Thank you for watching my videos. Thank you all.